think there's been a misunderstanding between you and I.
Wildfire's mine.
No, it's no misunderstanding at all.
Burning through the old
I think we both recognize one another for exactly who we are.
What do you want? Long term, for you.
I want to rip out the f***ed up machinery in this place. I want to tear it all down. For good.
You know him from What Men Want, straight out of Compton, and the TV show Leverage. Now, Aldis Hodge is starring alongside Kevin Bacon, the new Showtime crime drama City on a Hill.
Ooh, you scared me a little bit there.
Yeah, a little bit. You dirty talker.
Just a little bit. And a couple of bleeps out of
it. Man, so this show, we've seen the trailers running on Showtime. Is it one of these old-time Boston crime dramas? You're the good guy, Kevin Bacon's the bad guy. It looks like you guys have great chemistry.
So that's the thing is... I'm not really sure who's really good, who's really bad. A thing that we do beautifully with the show is we play the duality of people because I am, you know, this ADA who's coming in to clean up Boston crime and do it the right way. Kevin is a crooked FBI agent, but what we learn is that sometimes you gotta play a little dirty, you know, to get the job done. And, you know, we play both sides of the fence with all these characters.
I thought I read that this was set in the 90s. Is that not true? Cool. Well, I was expecting more New Jack City here, like like the hair I used to have.
No, it gets there. It gets there. This is 1992, man, where we're set. We are Boston, gritty as it gets, old school. Kevin's fantastic. Our entire cast is fantastic. And our creator, Chuck McLean, he's from Boston. So you're going to get like... The best thing about it is every time we read a script, I know exactly what lines Chuck wrote because
really?
There's this real authentic Boston nature to it. But he's dialed in and it's a great, great project.
I remember a few years ago they were talking about all these talk shows and reality shows that were going to get rid of work for actors. And now it's got to be a great time to be an actor with all of these venues, Showtime. You had WGN America where you did Underground and you won the SAG Award. I mean,
exactly.
It's got to be the projects you can do on these smaller venues have got to be fantastic for you guys.
Yeah. I mean, right now, like, Showtime is a fantastic house for us to be in because we get the support to be as free as we need to be.
Yeah.
And with a crime drama like this, we have to be raw. We can't just be surface level, just, you know, by the books, crime, bad guy, get captured, done. No, we love to play into the lives of people. For me, it's more of a psychological thriller because we get to play into why people do what they do in order to survive. And that's why crime is an issue, is because they're just trying to survive. And we get to understand the other side of how it affects their lives, their marriages, you know, all that. So we get to really have substance.
That's great.
You, correct me if I'm wrong, got your start in acting with your brother on Die Hard with a Vengeance.
Yeah.
How did that go?
Actually, you know, it was good. We started a little earlier than that. Actually, it was Sesame Street for a couple of years.
What?
Yeah.
You're doing a puppet or what? What did you do?
Nah, man. There's like a group of kids at
the end. Oh, you were one of the kids on Sesame Street?
No. Oh, that is so funny.
Come
I can tell you how to get to Sesame Street. Yeah.
What was that like as a kid?
Oh, it was
that
awesome.
That was every kid's dream.
Yeah, it was awesome. But we eventually worked our way to Die Hard, which was great because in that particular film, I played Sam Jackson's nephew. And I didn't know who he was at the time or Bruce Willis because I wasn't allowed to watch their movies. But Sam gave my mom a great note about acting. You know, he said, if your kids want to learn the foundation of acting, get them on stage. And oddly enough, after that film, we had an audition for a Showboat on Broadway and ended up doing that, for a little while. And you definitely learn, the tricks and you learn who you are as an actor when you hit the stage.
Wow. So Sesame Street, Die Hard, Broadway.
Yeah.
All of these things, and you're not old enough to have done all these things already.
Yeah, I feel old. Yeah. I feel like I'm 157.
Right. Were your parents Marines?
Both of them were Marines.
And you said, we want to be actors, and they said, great.
Well, my brother said it first. When he was 3 years old, he kept telling my mom he wanted to be in the box, and he kept pointing to the TV. So she was like, all right, well, that's the box. He wanted to be like on the Cosby Show. So, we moved to Jersey. We were stationed in Hawaii at the time, but we moved to Jersey. And she started supporting him in it. And then after that, I just kind of followed suit trying to be like him and trying to do jobs for Batman toys. So.
Well, thanks so
Very
much
cool.
for getting up early with us.
Oh, no, thank you
it's
for having me.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Aldis Hodge. It's City on a Hill airs Sundays at 7 p.m. Central Time on Showtime. It looks great. Thanks so much for being here.
Oh, thank you.